Now we will invite Dr. Tarek Radwan to talk about AVM lessons learned from IMC experience.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thanks, my chairman. I would like to share with you our lesson learned from the IMC experience in the AVM management. This is my disclosure. Congenital vascular malformation, as we all know, are one of the most common congenital and neonatal abnormalities, and they were often misdiagnosed and left untreated. This is the ISSVA classification, and from this classification, we know that AVM is a high flow, low resistance communication between the arterial and venous system without an intervening normal capillary system. They are most complex type of AVM. It has significant hemodynamic alteration, so you could have an, a high cardiac output failure, arterial insufficiency, and chronic venous hypertension. So the way for the success is proper diagnosis and early and appropriate treatment. We depend on the, you know, there is many classifications in the literature, but for, from when we started in 2005, we depend on the EX AVM classification, which he categorized the angiographic architecture into four types, either type one with direct communication, type two if there is an intervening nidus, type three is the nidus in the vein wall itself, either directly or with multiple veins, or type four, which is the most complex with minute innumerable microfistural communication. So you need to proper classify each type, and so you can do the proper management. So this is one of the keys of the success. Our vascular malformation services, we have all our experience learned from Professor Wynex from Colorado. We started 2005, 2-3 visits per year, and you can see how the workload is increasing from 4 cases in 2005 until nearly 90 cases in August and December 2017. This is done usually in continuous 3.5 days work. I'm sorry. So our cases in the AVM, we have for the AVM and 25 cases, which represent 21% of the whole vascular malformation cases, 15 females and 8 males, and the age ranged from 15 months to 55 years. This is the site distribution, mainly in the head and the neck 8 cases, and lower limb and pelvis 5 cases each. We have all the types of AVM, EX types, 1 to 5, 1 to 4, and the old mixed types. And we have treating session for the AVM, 149 session per 25 cases. Our treatment protocol depends on a day case under general anesthesia, transcatheter super selective ethanol embolization plus direct injections. You have to stick to the rationale of ethanol doses of 0.1 milli per kilogram ideal body weight every 10 minutes. And this is very crucial, so to avoid the increase in the pulmonary pressure to any significant degree, so cardiopulmonary collapse was obviated. Routine post-operative non-steroidal anti-inflammatory, tapering steroids and H2 receptor antagonists for about 1 week, and then post-procedure monitoring for 6 hours, and then discharge. This one, I'll show you three cases of our serious. Case one, she's 15 years old, the girl presented by bleeding from an infected foot ulcer following surgical intervention. This type 2A AVM, for which super-selective ethanol injection, you can see the rapid outflow vein in the first, and then you do the super-selective ethanol embolization. After some injections, you will find disappearance of the rapid outflow vein, but still she have a huge capillary venous malformation, for which direct puncture techniques in a repeated session was done. And then this one of the direct puncture here with ethanol injection in many treatments. This girl has treatment for nearly 6 years with us. And this is the how the improvement of her nasty ulcer, the presenting complaint, and now she's already, this photo is just the end of the last year, enjoying her playing tennis. She's sending this for us to show us how she's much improved. Her second case, and I left upper periorbital EX type 2A AVM, 15 years old girl, presenting by supraorbital swelling, and you can see in the CT angio, for which superselective is a null embolization through the anterior temporal artery branches. You do the raw mapping, and then you start to inject continuously with direct and superselective catheterization. This type of the one-stop shop treatment, because after injection of around 24 milli of isinol injected, you can see at the end the completion angiogram with the disappearance of the nidus and the whole AVM. This here CT follow-up 1 month after the procedure, no swelling, you can see it. And this here follow-up 3 months follow-up angiography also with disappearance of the AVM. And this her pre and 3 months follow-up photo. She's quite happy now. This girl is from here, from Upper Egypt, so you might see her outside. The case three is 32 years old female, presented by low back pain for years, radiating to the left lower limb. You can see the huge type 3A AVM, pelvic AVM, from both internal and external, both internal iliac arteries, right and left, and for which a superselective embolization. You, in this type, you have to do the direct puncture retrograde venous flow, and you put in a large coil. So if you put many coils, it will not be pushed upward to the pulmonary circulations. So you put in a large coil, and then you fill with direct coil punctures from outside. She has 39 coils inserted. This also a one-stop shop treatment, and after this you continue with isinol injection. This here is the difference between on the right the pre-injection and the completion angiogram difference, with disappearance of the huge outflow vein. This here 2 months follow-up CT angiography with disappearance of the AVM, and this here 3 months follow-up selective angiography, completely disappearance of the rapid outflow vein and the nidus. So our results and complication in isinol embolization of AVM, the therapeutic outcomes known in the literature, it could be cure, it could be symptom relief or signs improvement, and degree of devascularization and follow-up angiography. But you have an reported potential complication, many reported complication, from just tissue necrosis up to pulmonary artery hypertension and the cardio collapse. In our series 25 cases, we have 9 patients were cured, 13 patients having going treatment with symptom improvement, and 3 patients lost for follow-up. We have no major complication, only minor bleeding from the presenting foot ulcer in one session treated by direct compression. So the lesson learned is the detailed knowledge of EX classification, AVM type of angio architecture, vascular hemodynamics with anatomic consideration of normal vascular systems are crucial for successful treatment and minimizing complication. The second lesson learned is starting with fully experienced physicians allow for faster ramp up experience and minimize a steep learning curve with higher complication rate. Also, one center of excellence engaged with a larger malformation patient population is better than many centers managing too few cases in this most challenging area of vascular medicine. And lastly, for optimal treatment, a dedicated vascular malformation team should be in place. Thank you.